Hello, today we have an iPhone SE, the old model. It's not charging at all. This is the board I already taken out. I didn't want to make a very long video. So, as you know, like it's a common issue to get problems with the charging IC. On basically all the iPhones, they have this issues, you know. Could be either because of a bad charger or it's just because it's failing, you know. So this is the board. I will have to locate the charging IC. Basically, it's somewhere between these two screw holes. And I won't use the heat because I don't really like to do that. Sometimes I do use the heat to remove the shield. But today I will only cut the metal shield on this side and we'll see how it will go. Let's start cutting. Okay, we just make some lines like that so we can follow them. Probably cut too much, but it's all right. I don't mind. Come on. Don't press very hard. Just need these lines in order to break the metal. Well. Okay, so now I have a nice pillar. We're gonna start from a corner where we have access, and we just do like that, very carefully. Don't want to touch any component. You see how it's going on the line once you cut it. Is it here or it's on this side? It's on the other side. Okay, no problem. Okay. So there are plenty of metals that you can use, you know, in order to remove the shield. You can use like a grinder, you know, with a small blade and you can cut there. Or you can just use like a knife, precision knife, and you will do the same thing. Okay. Here. It is quite a long time since I've done one charging IC. It's mostly done for data recovery. Because nobody's using, almost nobody's using this, like iPhone 5C, 5S or SE. This is SE old model. So, yeah, we have here the little guy. As you can see, yeah, this is the little guy that is making us troubles. So let's remove it. Hopefully, I can see better. We start by removing the glue around the IC. Just go like easy around the IC. And it will go. Make sure that we don't touch any other component. We are done. Well, now you see this thing is moving here, yeah? So we're gonna just take it out. That's it. That means that the board is too hot. It's already reached the melting point, melting temperature. You wait a little bit because we don't want it to have it very, very hot. And see, this IC beside the charging IC, it's also like underfilled, which is not really good. but we won't have any issue with this. So what I'm gonna do, I'm increase the temperature. I put display like that. See? You see how nice it is? Like, it's gone. I took out the IC very easy without heating up the components around, because if it's under filled, it's not great to reach the melting point, because of course the solder will probably detach from the parts, and they might also short. So basically it won't work. So we have here like a very nice parts. Now we just gonna clean up the parts, remove this glue. Ready to put a new IC. Problem is that I don't really have an IC. Out from another board. I really hope I have one somewhere here, but not sure. Okay, let's remove the it's not focusing. Some part moving already. This is moving. This is not great. And this blade is not really nice. This blade is a bit too big, but I won't change it now, it's okay. Okay. So yeah, now we clean up the parts. Of course, we apply some flux. A bit too much, but it's all right. So very gently. We turn around the other part as well. go very gently on the parts. Parts are looking all right. Let's clean it up so we can see better. Okie dokie, let's find the wick. Oh yeah, we go all around until we remove the whole part, yeah? Sorry, not the part, the whole solder parts. Parts is never good to remove them. So don't do that. See, one part is gone, but I suppose that one doesn't have any connection. It's just like nothing used. I will check in the schematic, but as far as I know, it's not connected to any relevant component. Stubborn. I feel. So let's clean up everything properly. See if we have any look, everything looks all right. Yeah, it's okay, everything fine, no problem at all. We can put a new IC. Good. Yeah, all good. So let's see this part, what's the story with this one. As you can see, it's no connection. You can already see that if it was any moment. It's shaking. So if it was any connection on this part, you would see, you know, like you would see under, or you would see on the side, like exactly like, one moment, you see this one here, is connected, yeah? This one is connected to this pad. You see this, and so long. So this one doesn't have any problem that we to get out, you know? Of course, it's better not to, but sometimes they go out, you know, and it's not really a big deal. So now, okay, so there is some glue around here. I don't really like to have any glue. We'll remove it so the new IC it will fit properly. Have one more here on this corner. It's all right. Always, if you want to do this, press gently, because you might scratch the board like here, and it might get shorted when you put back the IC. All good. Now, where can I find an IC? This is the problem. Not sure if I have any IC. If I have any IC left, that's the problem. Just check around here. If not, we're gonna take from another board. Take from another board and just reball it. That's it. No, we don't need to waste time, you know. Now I'm just zero eight three. So, like, of course, you can take from a same model if you have a board, you know, or, you know, these are compatible, you know, they are interchangeable. So you can go easily online, on eBay or anywhere you want. Check the number it's 161083. You just type 161083 U2 IC, yeah? And then, like now I'm on Google, yeah? One moment. Okay? And now you can see exactly, like, where you can get the IC, you know, like from which board. And let's see. It's you see here, like AC6 6S plus charging IC. So that means that you can find this IC on of course on iPhone AC other board, on iPhone 6, 6S, and probably 6S plus. Yeah. And the best thing to do is to go on AliExpress, so because they put better description, you see? So for iPhone 6, 6S and 6S plus, yeah. So now, if I find a board for, I find a board like now, I take from a good working iPhone 6, 6S or 6S Plus, I can just take the chip out and that's it, reball it and put it on. So now I'm just going to pause the video until I find a board and then I will be back. Okay, so I am back. Here, a board here. The same IC. We'll see now. You see the IC is there, yeah? Of course, same. You can use this. You can use heat, but heat is not great. Look, A61083. Okay. So now we safely remove this IC. I'm so glad that it's not underfilled. We safely removed the IC. Little bit of board. This is out. The little guy. A little bit of flux, a little bit. Idea. We find a stencil. I'm gonna use a brand new stencil that I just got it. Just because I want to test it in the same time. It looks like nice stencil. Okay, and let's find the charging IC, which is right where. Is it this one? Funny. Oh yeah. How nice it's sitting on. Yeah. See better. Okay. I solder paste. Dry up a little bit this solder paste. Yeah, should dry it up. Let it. Now it's dried up, and let's apply some heat. Okay. Duki. It's one ball that he didn't. It's back now. So why is not focusing my camera? Look how nice it is. Look, I think this IC looks amazing. So now we go on the board. Get ready the IC, we just put it here. We put it there. We put a little bit of flux. Of course, a little bit, probably it will be a lot. It's okay. And now let's check how it will go. It will go exactly probably like this. Taken out, it will go. Tricky. You have to clean up the tweezer, you know, if you don't want to stick on the tweezer. Okay, now everything is in place and let's back. See straight away that it will basically look like it will fall on the board, you know? Done. You see how? That's it. That's it. So now it's sitting perfectly on the board. It's soldered. And we're gonna do a test. See how nice it is. I'm gonna try to turn on my top camera, but I was out of battery and I couldn't charge it. Let's see if we can working. Oh, okay. That's all right. So now the IC is done. Okay. And we have to put down this antenna back in place. Just put it back in place nicely. If you don't see well, go under the microscope. You make sure that it's in the right spot. As you can see, there is some glue there. It will sort it. Sort it or not. Made the, you know, the click noise. You make sure that the cable is secured. Secured, everything okay. Change on the top camera. Oh yeah, we're gonna install it. We will install it and make it ready like for we have to put this cable back. See. Everything is all right, looks okay. Come on. Is done. Now it's done. Install the charging port. Let's install the screen as well, just for the test. Yeah, all good. Now, off to. Probably we have to wait a while, just because the I think the battery is too empty. I am gonna play with a new battery. Let's try to turn it on with a new battery. Which is interesting. Draining any amps. Okay. So is there any other problem, or is it diagnose the charging IC? We will see soon enough. I see solder properly. Interesting. Okay, so I have actually a short on VCC main, I suppose. Let's see. This is ground. This should be not zero, so we have zero. Okay, we have a short on VCC main. We misdiagnosed the charging IC, unfortunately. Sometimes you are just thinking that it's just charging IC, because the values on the charging dock, they are different, but sometimes could be short on VCC main. If you have a tester like an ICC Pro, you can easily see, like, if it's showing you like TriStar Hydra fail, or it's showing you like short on VCC main, or just showing you like check the charging port. But because I didn't have that, I only took the measurements from the dock. I said, okay, what can be, you know? This can happen to everyone. Like, it's not not something, you know, to worry. But now we have a short on VCC main. Short on VCC main, and we will have to find out what's the story, you know? It's not really hard to find the short on VCC main. Now I'm thinking, you know, the IC, this IC, yeah, you see beside. Did I overheat it a little bit? Which I don't think so, but who knows? And maybe I caused a short, or it's just this was the actual problem. We will see soon enough. What we're gonna do now? iPhone cables to test it. We will connect the power supply. So we can just test the board. Just looking now for a cable for iPhones. Wait, access. I cannot find the like this. I said I haven't done iPhone 5S since probably a few months ago. It's a bit hard to find it. Like this. Okay. I think I found one. That one, or it's another one? Could be. Yeah, this one is okay. We connect the power supply. The amperage. We don't want too many amps. Okay. find where is the heat coming from. Of course, it's showing us short. Increase the amps. Is the heated spot. Okay. All right, so we will take out the shield. We will remove the whole shield in this case. Remove the whole shield and we'll see what we can do. It's strange. Everything was showing us that it's charging IC issue. But look like it's not, and we have to fix it. There are sometimes this can happen. Can happen to everyone, like it's nothing. Now maybe you're wondering why you didn't measure the VCC main from the beginning, because I was blinded by the testing, you know, like I tested the charging IC, but of course if it's a VCC main short circuit, it could also be like a problem with the VCC. It will be showing bad measurements on the dock measurement. It's not really great. Change something here. Okay, now it's much better. So let's remove the shield. Yeah, you go from a corner. Yeah, the shield is removed. Do you see this little guy here? Range, but it's same on this side, so yeah, maybe yeah, but anyway, now we are able to see where the heat is coming from, you know. Uh-huh. Oh no, it's not a hole. I thought it's a hole, it's just glue. Yeah, it's just glue. This is like power management, I see, I suppose. Okay. So yeah, this one is not looking great here, you see? I'm not sure if this is part of VCC main, but always inspect the board, then check on the schematic, see if this component, you see this component, yeah, it's connected on VCC main, and most likely this one is faulty, you know. But yeah, let's go on the schematic, on the board view, sorry, and let's see that component. This one, and it is on VCC main. You see this one, it is on VCC main. See? This guy here. Okay? It is connected on VCC main, as you can see on the board view. Exactly second capacitor, not first, second one, yeah? VCC main. So most likely that capacitor it's causing the short on the board. Now we can try just to like for to see, you know, how is this acting under the power supply. Is this hot, is getting hot or not? Yeah, so we'll see now. Change on camera. I just have a new setup on my camera, and you know, maybe it's not great, but I'm getting there. So yeah, let's connect back the power supply. Power supply is connected back. Yeah. I want to see the board. The board is hot, it's not hot. Also the NAND, you see, it looks like it had some, maybe just, maybe it was the flux that that I sold at the U2IC. So, not an issue. I will go exactly where it where I see that capacitor, okay? Look, did you see? You saw that capacitor straight away. That is the first that is getting hot. You see it, yeah? So that's why I'm telling you, like, we could only spot that one, like, because it's not looking great, and one side it's burned, like, you know. And yeah, change under the microscope. It's exactly same capacitor that we saw. Exactly this guy here, and you can see, like, straight away, you can see the mark of burn and. It's basically in bad shape. I will try to remove this one. So you see how it got, like, I didn't even have to apply any pressure and the capacitor went out. Because there are so many capacitors on VCC main, I don't really see, I mean, it's good to have one more, but there are plenty of them. Let's see, actually, let's go on the schematic. So we have one here, yeah? Up here, one more. So here, and plenty of capacitors, you know, that this one, let's see, one moment, I just want to see 0.86, 0.87, VCC main, you see, it's also on the schematic, yeah, 0.86, so look how many they are, same value, yeah, look, and probably more there on the other side. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4. So it's a lot of protection here. This it will work even with this capacitor, you know? It will definitely work. Now you can either, like, get a board, find a board, replace the capacitor, I mean replace it, just install the capacitor and that's it. And yeah, let's do it. It's just, I don't want to, you know, to want this to look like, you know, like a dodgy job, you know, because this is not my intention. But I'm sure that it will work, you know, so I can tell you for sure that it will work. Just I have to find, you know, board that. We have the values, you know, like, it was 10 microfarad. Hard spot here to reach. Okay. I know maybe it looks like mess, but it's a very tight spot, so just have to take it slowly. You see there, we have some bridges. If it doesn't want to go out, we can just tweak it a little bit. It and just do like that until it's going. Yeah, so the bridge is gone. Time just to see. That's it. Now let's find the board. The worst part. And I really wish that I find a board that am I so lucky? I think we have found it. Right. Okay, so between that I see. I've touched a little bit this coil, but it's okay. It's not bad. It will work. Okay. So we go from, you see this IC, you can take like a int, and the second capacitor is ours. So just steal it from that board. This tweezer, it's yeah, so this is ours now. We stole it. Yeah. Okay. A little bit more flux. A lot more, actually. Not to put too much heat on the board. So it's looking okay. We still have to do something, but always don't put too much heat. Always. We have components around underneath on the other side. It's probably the CPU and never. Okay. So look. It's exactly like brand new. Clean it up now. ID. as you can see, looks like me. I clean up more. I'm using 200 degrees, you know, to remove the flux from the board. Everything looks all right. So the flux that I'm using, it's Amtec. It's NC559N2PF. And this is no clean flux. So if any flux is left there, it's not really an issue. Okay. So now we can simply just put back the power supply. Of course, if the board is still hot, it's better to wait, you know, like never turn it on when it's hot. And we will see the current. Is it any short? Everything is back to normal. So if you think, I'm thinking about this, this could be like a very easy repair. Yeah, just remove the whole shield, plug in the DC power supply, and find the short. Yeah, using thermal camera or just do visual inspection, and you would be finding the short circuit. But if I would go in that way, you wouldn't learn, yeah? So you wouldn't get nothing from this video, only by doing that. I suppose you would only see changing the IC, charging IC, simple like that, and that's it. But I'm sure, like most of you, you had issues, some other issues from misdiagnosing the problem, because of course, I measured, like I have the values here. Like these two values were showing exactly same like fault, like it would be the charging IC, but because the charging IC is also connected to the VCC main. Of course, in this case, it's showing bad. But if you want to save your time, you can buy an ICC Pro, which I have it somewhere here, but it's faulty, and I ordered another one. I couldn't fix it because the screen is faulty, and I cannot find the screen on its own. And it will save you a lot of time, because most of the time that ICC Pro is showing you like VCC short, you know, and you will know it's not the charging IC. So now I turn on the power supply. Looks fine. It looks all right. I don't know why this thing is showing, like it's making this noise. This mechanic boot cable. Anyway, doesn't matter. No bother. And okay. We forget about one thing. We need this antenna. And this shield. Okay, we make sure that it's matching the holes. Focus. We go like that. Let's see. like that all over. Go all over until we have it folded back. Everything looks all right, it's soldered back, and let's put it on. Microscope again. Be sure that it's everything okay. So I don't see anything. Yeah, so cable is sitting all right. We push this a little bit. He's okay. Yeah. Let's see what's the story. Do we have an working iPhone AC or not? Okay. Same, I'm gonna install the screen to see if everything is all right. This one. And that one. Just want to see if it's working, if we get any display, if it's charging, and if so, it will be ready to go. What we have there? We have a logo. The current response is fine. And we have an working iPhone. Yeah, guys, so if you like the video, please like and subscribe. You can leave some comments. Maybe we can share some experiences. But yeah, I could straight away, you know, like go measure the VCC main and this kind of things. But if, as I said, you wouldn't learn. I'm sure plenty of you did the charging IC and there were some other issues and you just left it away because you were thinking that you are not able to fix it. I'm sure you are able to fix everything as long as you want to push further, you know? So, yeah. I'm just checking the current to see if everything is all right. Yeah, everything looks all right. Okay, I'm just gonna install the phone back. I will close the video now because there's no point to do anything, like, you know, it's done. Okay, have a good day. Thank you for watching.